from the cognitive psychology side, the main thing I do with my kids, my kids are young, so I don't try and teach them sophisticated strategies for learning things. I mostly want them to use their own strategies, but I want them not to be afraid of failing. I want them to try a math problem, try a one that is a little bit beyond their ken, beyond their ability, and fail at it, and think about why they fail at it, and think about what kind of knowledge they would need to get better at it, and to not feel bad about failing at it. That seems to me a good place to start with kids. Mistakes provide one of those teachable moments, right? Because it's diagnostic for where the process went wrong. Given the type of mistake that's made, you can kind of figure out where it is that this person didn't apply the right strategy. So they're useful for that purpose. Letting kids work through problems, one thing I see all the time, and I don't work with teachers that much, so I don't know if teachers do this, but I see this with parents all the time, is that a kid is working through a problem, the parent gets frustrated with their lack of progress and tells them the answer. I mean, that's like the critical moment. This kid is about to have that insight that's going to let them figure out the relationship between division and multiplication or whatever little thing it is that they're working through. And the parent is either worried about how this looks to other people who are watching or is frustrated with the progress of the kid, wants them to be smarter instantly, and gives them the answer and deprives them of the opportunity of working through it. Working through these things is critical. You can't just get answers. Our minds are not just associations between problems and solutions. It's a process. Working through that process and letting kids work through that process and have all the failures that are attendant to that is critical. I think a lot of the time people can't benefit from mistakes is because they're afraid of the consequences of those mistakes. And sometimes those are internal, they feel bad about themselves, and sometimes they're external because I see coaches yelling at kids all the time for making mistakes. You're right, when you remove that fear of failure, kids can try new things, trying new strategies for doing things, you know, trying to make a layup on your offhand side. That's really important because you're not going to learn it if you don't try. You'll never learn those things are hard. Then what people start doing is they start doing the things they're good at and avoiding the things they're bad at. The earlier in life that happens, the more this kid is setting up for themselves a life where they're not going to grow and expand. They're just going to do the few things they happen to serendipitously be good at early in life.